Hey there, my creative friend. Do you use QuickBooks Online and Dubsado? Do you have sales tax? Today I'm going to walk you through how to integrate QuickBooks and Dubsado and get sales tax to sync over nice and smooth so you have accurate financial reports and tax liability reports to file your sales tax. So let's dive in.
Real quick, before we get started, I just want to point you to a link in the description, which is to another YouTube video I have called Sales Tax 101. This will walk you through everything you need to know and consider about your business and your state and sales tax prior to setting everything up. So there's that link if you need a little bit of extra guidance on sales tax. I'm now going to show you what it looks like when you go to integrate Dubsado with QuickBooks Online, but you have not yet turned on sales tax in QuickBooks. This is the Dubsado dashboard. You're going to go up to the gear. You're going to click on settings. You will go to integration. You'll see QuickBooks here and you'll connect to QuickBooks. It's going to bring you to a window where you can pull up your account. I have several because I'm a pro advisor, so you should only have your one account there in the dropdown. Once Dubsado has been integrated with QuickBooks Online, you now have the options. You'll see here you can automatically sync invoices to QuickBooks Online after a payment is received, or automatically sync payments to QuickBooks Online after a payment is received. So this is syncing the payment. This is syncing the invoice. You can toggle these on or off. You'll notice down here you have the QuickBooks Online sales tax codes. To correctly sync your Dubsado invoices into your QuickBooks Online account, please import your tax rates from your QuickBooks account into Dubsado. When I click on this, there is gibberish in here, and that's because I've connected and reconnected many times. You will click on this and you will have no options, and that's how you know that you have not turned on sales tax inside of QuickBooks Online. So how do you turn on sales tax inside of QuickBooks Online? You'll go into your QuickBooks Online file. On the left, you'll go to taxes and you'll see this screen if you have not been set up yet. So you'll set up sales tax. So I had it turned on before, so it's turning it back on for me. So I have a demo file here and I use several different examples for different videos. So I have a couple different states here. Now, when we pop back over to Dubsado, we can see if we go to select, each of those tax codes are here. So I can add them in as an option to be selected on invoices inside of Dubsado, which will then sync over to QuickBooks. Out of scope is for things that don't have sales tax. Now we're going to go over to reporting and click on the invoice listing. We can see here now that we have two invoices that have not been synced over to QuickBooks Online. In order to sync them over, I'm going to click on the three dots and sync invoice and payments. We get the message invoice and its payments will be synced to QuickBooks. We now see that this is pending. A quick refresh will show us that there was an error. So let's go ahead and take a look inside of this invoice and then go to the project. So we see the sales tax of 8.75% here. If I expand this line to edit it, I can see a manual sales tax item. So if you manually set up sales tax at any point in Dubsado to go on invoices prior to integrating with QuickBooks Online, you're going to have to fix these lines. So let me hit cancel and show you how this is done. You would come into that invoice and you would come to the QuickBooks tax code. There's a red asterisk here, which means this is required in order for it to sync over to QuickBooks. I'll click this drop-down menu and select New York Erie, which is my New York Erie County tax. You'll see the 8.75. Watch what happens. It's now split up. So it's still 8.75, but 4% goes to New York State and 4.75 goes to the county. And it knows this because it's getting this information from QuickBooks Online. So now we can go back to reporting, go to the invoice listing. Let's go ahead and resync now that we fixed that. Click retry. Again, it's pending. Let's go ahead and do a quick refresh and we see that it's synced over. So let's pop over to QuickBooks Online now and see what it looks like in there. So we're in QuickBooks on the dashboard. Now let's go to sales. We will type in the customer name. There he is. We can see invoice 4 is here, which is the same invoice 4 for Han Solo. The payment is here. Let's go ahead and check this out. Go into the invoice. We can see the sales tax is being calculated here. You can see that New York is getting 4%. Erie County is getting 4.75%. Beautiful. Now we can pull a sales tax report. So on the left in QuickBooks Online, go to taxes. And you'll notice here for June, which is the date of the invoice that we just synced over, it's showing me it was due July 20th because today is July 27th, so I haven't filed this. It's a demo file and this is just a hypothetical, but you see $80.46 of sales tax. When I click on view return, we're going to see gross sales for the period and the taxable sales. Now, notice that number is $919.54. We cancel this. We go to our reports. We'll look at a profit and loss. And if we look at this and open it up, we're going to see the same number inside here for Han Solo. It's the $919.54. We're going to open it up. I'll go to more and I will show you the transaction journal for this. So you'll see accounts receivable is showing $2,718.75. That's the total invoice with the sales tax. $2,500 of that is going to be going to service income. $100 of that will go to New York State. And then $118 will go to the local county. So that's what makes up this invoice. And now we only received a payment of $1,000. So when we go to taxes, we're going to go to reports and run a sales tax liability report. It's going to show us $919.54. Is the taxable amount of the $1,000, and the $3,678 and the $4,368 are the taxes that are included in the $1,000 payment. So you are only paying sales tax on what you actually physically collected. Think about if you were to pay sales tax on everything that you've invoiced out and somebody canceled or changed, now you have to go back and constantly be fixing previous periods of sales tax with credits. So this is the cash method. So you are only reporting what you physically have in hand, which is the $1,000 payment, which means only $80.46 of that will be going to sales tax for this particular sales tax period. If payments are made in the future in other sales tax periods, it will calculate how much of those payments are due to go to sales tax at that time as well. This is the report that you would pull in order to go online and pay your sales tax. Everything you need is here. Being able to integrate with your favorite CRM and know that everything coming into your books is correct. If we also run a report and look at the balance sheet, you'll see here on your balance sheet, the New York Department of Taxation and Finance, because this is New York sales tax, right now currently owe them $80.46. It shows up on your financials where it's supposed to be. I hope that helps you in integrating Dubsado and QuickBooks together and how to use sales tax effectively between the two. I hope that shed some light on this topic for you. If you're interested in learning more about these types of topics, I'd love for you to join my free Facebook community. You'll find the link down below in the description for this video. I hope to see you there. Don't forget to subscribe.